Hey, it's Danny, and today we're going to be installing a strap button on my Dreadnought-style Parkwood acoustic guitar. I started by marking the spot where I wanted to install the strap button, roughly halfway between the back of the neck and the back of the heel of the neck, almost on the bottom side. I wasn't happy with the first mark I made, so I tried rubbing it off with a wet paper towel. That didn't work, so I used a Lysol wipe, and that did the trick. It came with only one strap button where you plug the jack in, and I had been tying a rope around the headstock underneath the strings to attach the strap on the other side. But I didn't like the balance of the guitar when I secured it this way. It shifted the guitar too far toward the picking hand side of my body. I was happy with the second mark. Next, I used the screw from the strap button to tap a little guide dent to prepare for drilling the guide hole. To drill the guide hole, I chose a drill bit that was roughly the minor diameter of the screw. I did my best to drill perpendicular to the curve of the heel of the neck. This was my first time drilling into a guitar, so I was a bit nervous. Although this guitar has been with me since about 2006 and went through some serious damage. The headstock cracked off and I had to glue it back on, and there was also some damage on the top and sides where UPS crushed it while I was shipping it off for a minor repair. Ironic, I know. I double-checked the length of the shank of the screw to make sure my pilot hole was deep enough. This is the pack of strap buttons I ordered from Amazon. It's funny how it always seems to be a better deal to get way more than you need. I'm not sure when I will need to install 11 more strap buttons, but when that time comes, I'll be ready. The strap buttons came with little rubber washers to help give a tight fit. If you're enjoying this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. I have lots of videos featuring this guitar. Next, I screwed in the strap button. But I had to back it out a bit and redo it because the rubber washer wasn't quite centered. I'm very happy with how this turned out. The balance while wearing the guitar has been much more comfortable. Thanks for watching. If this was helpful for you, hit those thumbs up and subscribe buttons below, and check out my other videos featuring this guitar. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Have fun playing your guitar, and I'll see you in the next video.